In this episode, we deal with the perils of deception and the sometimes necessity to lie to oneself in order to get through that.
What are you gonna walk to Chicago?
I'm not gonna just sit here waiting for orders. They're not gonna come.
What episode 103 shows is that Miles really started with the best of intentions. And he really set out to help people and to protect people in a way that the US government wasn't able to.
How many bodies have we come across?
Hungry people get desperate.
Yeah.
But this? Ain't nobody coming to help. With the best of intentions, we started out as brothers, and when the chaos hit, both of them were up and ready to serve the common good.
Get away from him.
As things evolved, things started to go haywire, and one continued on a path that the other one didn't agree with.
The Monroe Militia is in so many ways this Frankenstein monster that Miles made and now can't control.
He's controlling a massive part of what was once America.
So Aaron and Maggie in episode 3, you know, they go to Grace's house and she's not there and she's gone and something awful happened to her. There's this whole other situation going on of these people who have these necklaces and what are they trying to do? These sort of mysterious characters. We wanted to introduce Randall early because we wanted people to see that not all of those people are good because they have these necklaces that makes them very, very dangerous people.
Grace?
When Aaron and Maggie show up at Grace's house, there's just this fire going in Aaron, and he's looking for whatever signs he can to back up his story. And they go up to the attic, and they find the computer, and everything's smashed and everything, but I mean, this has gotta be, I've gotta be right, this has gotta be it. And then just right at that moment, out of nowhere, the pendant starts to glow, and the power turns on.
And the look in Aaron's face when he hears Marvin Gaye for the first time in 15 years, and the look on Maggie's face when she doesn't even remember what her boys' faces look like anymore. And it's what power gives us. It's not about electricity, it's about electricity connects us with our friends and family and our passions and our loved ones, and when they're able to have that back and feel human and normal again, just for the split second that they do, that's just a really, really powerful moment. Seed stories are really fun because you can put the pressure on and then keep the pressure on. And then nerves fray and people bark at each other and you never know how you're gonna get out of it.
There's 50 men up there. You cannot stop them.
You know, that's what my dad used to say.
He was right. He was trying to protect you.
He was being a coward.
Don't ever, ever disrespect your dad. Are we clear?
I think Miles has probably had a long and illustrious life of failing Ben over and over and over again in countless different ways. And I think one of the reasons he's probably on this journey is he doesn't want to fail Ben one more time.
Miles took off and was in hiding instead of trying to find his brother to try and help his family. And I think that guilt weighs on him, and it's something that he finally showed for the first time and kind of gives Charlie a different perspective. You know this guy?
Oh, you really don't know, do you?
How do you know him?
We were really excited about 103. Like, we couldn't get to it fast enough. We just were holding on to this secret that had been in from the DNA of the character from the beginning.
This is Miles Matheson, commanding general of the Monroe Militia. Damn founding father of the Republic, second only to Sebastian Monroe himself. He taught me everything I know.
Miles?
It's an interesting moment because he wants to stay true to who he is and still try to be proud of who he is, but tough to do when he feels kind of vile about the things that he's done.
I think there's always a part of her that's just, you know, gonna be a little bit weary about it, wondering what it is that he's done and how he can justify that and who is this person.
You were in charge of the whole militia.
Now you know why the militia cannot be stopped, because they're mine.
He feels he needs to set that right. In his heart, almost against every impulse he has, he's a hero. And they get out of it by Miles sacrificing himself.
You let these people go, I'll turn myself in.
We thought it absolutely defined how difficult this mission is for him, because he's going up against his entire life, and he was loyal to these men and loved Monroe, and now he's got to take them all down. The closer he gets to Monroe, the closer he's going to get to facing his very own personal demons.